this story time did actually end up taking place quite a while ago now. To be specific, it actually took place in November of 2019, you know, before the whole pandemic and things started really, you know, just before Christmas. So anyways, at this time I was talking to this girl for about 3 weeks. Everything was going well. She was a really beautiful girl, really pretty, really gorgeous. You know, I really did, you know, like her, and not just her for looks, her as in a person as well. She was really sweet, really, you know, really sweet, warm-hearted, you know. So I can remember I was talking to her for about 3 weeks, and because she lives close to me, kind of, she lived probably around an hour away, we ended up, you know, agreeing to meet at this, you know, one city, at the train station and whatnot. So I can remember we planned this for the Saturday up and coming. So I can remember the Saturday comes, it's early in the morning, we, you know, sorted all the times out that we're going to meet the night before. She said she'll be there for about midday. I was like, okay, that's cool. So I get up early in the morning, you know, I tell my mum I'm going out. I actually lied and said I was going to a film with a friend, so make sure you believe me back then. And yeah, I just didn't really want to tell my mum, to be honest, because she'd be like, oh, Isaac, let me take you instead. And I didn't really want to deal with none of that, to be honest. So I can remember I get to the local train station and, you know, buy a ticket, I wait for the train. 15 minutes later the train arrives, and at this point I literally get on the train and go to that local city. So I can remember, you know, I'm literally just seeing them. I'll send her a text message, I'm like, oh, you alright? And she's like, yeah, I'm on the train now, I'll be about 20 minutes. So I can remember the 20 minutes rolls around, she ends up getting, you know, off the train. I'm like looking around like, okay, where could she be, you know, listen to a lot of people, to be honest, like, damn, okay. And she's like, she's at A on her second platform. And I was like, oh no, she's up on platform, like on the second platform. I was on the, you know, the underground bit. So I was like, okay, I've got to run upstairs. So I'm like, okay, I'm sorry, I'm on underground, you know, I'm on B underground. And she's like, okay, that's cool. She's gonna remember, I run up the stairs. I ask one of the dudes who works there, I'm like, you're right, mate, where's 2A? And he's like, oh man, he's just down there, it's like a 2 minute run. And I'm like, 2 minute run? He's like, yeah, if you run fast you'll get there because the train's leaving again. And I'm like, okay. I wasn't worried about that. I was just worried about distance. So, you know, I text the girl, I'm saying, I'll be this long, I won't be long, you know, because I just walk there, down this really long, like, corridor, and then, like, up, like, these little stairs, and, yeah, it was really complicated, I'm not gonna lie, it was a bit like a maze, but, yeah, you know, at first time meeting, I didn't want to be late or anything like that. So after about 3 minutes, I end up getting to her, I see her, I'm a bit out of breath, because I had a little jog as well. She's like, oh, alright, and I'm like, oh, how are you doing, like, you okay? And she's like, yeah, I'm fine. To be honest, she was shy at the start, I was a bit shy, you know, she was more shy than me, made it a little more awkward, but we dealt with that. So anyways, we actually decided on going to, you know, Nando's for some dinner. We went to Nando's, I can remember I had a butterfly chicken, had some chips, you know, some fries. She had butterfly chicken, but she had some sort of salad instead. We got the garlic bread as well. You know, you can get like them the dips and things, yeah. So basically, you know, we went to Nando's after obviously talking for a bit. We didn't just go straight for food. We talked for maybe half an hour. I've got most of the bits out that I don't want to implement into the video, or I don't want to put in, just because it was just a lot of us talking and kind of reminiscing. I won't say reminiscing, just going over, you know, things that we've, you know, that we've been doing whilst, you know, talking. So yeah, we was just going over that, but at this point we're just eating. So I can remember we're just eating our food, and we finish up our food, and as we're finishing, you know, I've started to get a real you know, cry for this girl. Like, I really do love this girl at this point. She's really smart, that's one. She's pretty, so pretty, I'm not gonna lie. And yeah, I did actually say, would you want to go to the cinema maybe? And she was like, oh yeah, there's a really good film on that I want to watch. I was going to tell you about it as well. I was just nervous to ask, just in case you didn't want to see. And I was like, what's the film? And she was like, it was like kind of a romantic slash comedy a bit. The film was, I can't remember the name of the film, just because it was so long ago, but I remember it was a romantic film. I remember after that is, we end up going to the cinema, and the cinema at this point is on like the main strip, kind of like the high street, because we're in like a town. But the cinema from the outside does not look like a cinema. It's like you're walking underground a little bit. It was funny, to be honest. Looking back, it was really funny. It's like you'd not expect that. So we end up going there. We end up going up to, you know, the front counter or whatnot. We go to the nearest counter. I'm just like, oh, Isaac, are you sure that you don't want to basically pick any other film? You know, like, I'll be happily watch someone else with you. And I'm like, nah, it's cool. Like, you know, it's a romantic film. It's a comedy. It'll be pretty cool. You can just sit and chill and watch that. So anyways, we had some very bad news. Well, bad news for us anyway. I don't know if it was bad. Well, yeah, it could have been good news if we went ahead, because I wouldn't have nearly made a break. But yeah, I'm going to get on to that. So anyways, we go up to the woman and, you know, the girl I was dating, let's just call her Megan. So Megan asked the woman, she was like, oh, is his film on? Like, I've heard it's really good. It's the love comedy one. And the woman was like, oh, I'm so sorry. Yeah, we finished, you know, we finished showcasing of that film today. You know, there's no more screens available. The last one was about 25 minutes ago, and you'll be pretty late to watching it anyway. And I was like, oh, okay. Even though, you know, I didn't really have an interest in the film too much, I was just like, it put a dampener on the mood. And then, you know, Megan, she was a bit upset as well. And then one was like, you can come back tomorrow, you know, we premiere again tomorrow. But we could not do that because we was only with each other for a day, you know. And then she went back to her hometown, I went back to mine. I didn't know at this point, you know, that we was going to be spending more than a day together. I just thought we was going there for the day, maybe, you know, eat up some food, have a walk around, you know, go cinema and just look up at the stars and chill. So at this point, you know, I am, you know, just with Megan, and I go up to this one dude and I'm like, all right, mate, you know, is there any more screenings on of this film? And he's like, nah, man, nah, there's not. And, you know, just asked a different guy at this point, been talking to the guy, and that Megan's like, Isaac, it's fine, come on, come outside, it's fine. Yeah, the guy kind of looked at me weird, and I looked at the guy, and he was like one of them looks of like, he knows and I know that she wants to get it on with me, just by the way the tone of voice and her looking at me was. He was like a nag, like she kind of like pulled me as well. It was really cute, I'm not gonna lie. So it was like, alright, mate. And he was like, yeah, man, stay safe, bro, you know, stay safe. He was pretty young, the guy was, I'd probably say at the time he was maybe 4-6 years tops older than me, you know. He was pretty young guy. So what ends up happening is we leave the cinema, and Megan does end up asking me, she's like, Isaac, would you want to get a hotel for the night? And at this point, my heart was kind of, you know, it was racing, you know. I could feel it racing, because I did not know, you know, what my mum would think if I'm staying out. She doesn't know where I am. Well, she does, because I told her I was staying at a friend. It was for the day. I didn't tell her I was staying over. So I don't know, because then I'd have to find my mum, and she's like, it's cool if you can't, you know. And I'm like, no. Let's stay in a hotel, let's find a hotel. So, without me telling my mom anything like that, we go to an hotel, we go to a premiere inn, you know, we go to this premiere inn, and we end up, you know, paying in, we end up getting a room. The woman at the desk and this other dude who were there, these two women at the desk end up giving me and the girl some really weird look. I think the reason was is because we were so young, or something like that, booking a hotel. I don't know, they probably knew what was going to happen. You know, even though we wasn't just going there for that, we was just going there, you know, just to chill. because I liked her so much. She took a really nice interest in me. She liked me a lot, as I could tell. And yeah, so I can remember, we've got this hotel. We literally have nothing with us, no extra clothes, nothing. And, like, you know, there's obviously showers in there. So, yeah, we did end up taking showers and that. Okay, so onto the interesting bit, just after I tell you this part. So as we're in the room, I end up getting a call from my mum. And she's like, oh, Isaac, where are you? Like, I'm meant to be going out. And at this point, it was coming on to like 7 p.m. It was pretty dark as well, because it was dark nights. And I'm like, mum, I'm staying at one of my mates, you know. She's like, no, Isaac, you're not. Like, you need to get back home here now. And I'm like, mum, I'm not. Like, I'm staying at my friend's. And we had a little argument. She was like, Isaac, you better get back here now, or I'm going to come to da-da-da-da-da. And that could not happen. I could not be letting her go to my friend's house. So what I ended up doing is, I ended up phoning my friend, especially without me being there. So I phoned my friend. I was like, mum, I'll phone you back. She's like, Isaac, no. So I phoned my friend. I'm like, bro, my mum might end up coming to your house. Can you literally tell her if she comes that I'm not here, and I've gone out and stayed at another friend's who you don't know, who's all together? Can you just say that? He's like, Isaac, I can't be done saying that to your mum. I can't lie to your mum. Your mum, like, your mum trusts me. Like, and I'm like, bro, can you do it? Yes or no? And he's like, I'll do it for you, bro. And I'm like, thank you, bye. So I put the phone down. I phone my mum back. I'm like, mum, I'm not staying at his anymore. I'm at a different friend's. He's like, Isaac, what's with all this switching up? Like, why are you lying to me? And I'm like, mum, I'm at a friend's. I'm just going to chill there for the night. I'll be back in the morning. I promise. I'm not doing anything bad. I'm not harming anyone. Just listen. Like, please, just for once. She's like, have you eaten? Da, 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 da. What are you doing? Are his parents fine with it? I'm like, yes. Yes, they're fine with it. Yes, I've eaten. I had a Nando's. And she's like, okay, make sure you're back early in the morning. And I'm like, I will be. And she's like, bye, Isaac. Have fun. And I'm like, thank you, mum. Goodbye. I love you. And she's like, Isaac, I love you too, you know, but stay safe. So anyways, at this point, the girl is looking at me. The girl's looking at me like, what the hell has just gone on? Because that all happened in such a short space of time. But still, at this point, you know, we just started talking. And, you know, I turned the main lights off. And I put, like, the lamps on, the two lamps behind the bed. She's like, Isaac, you're really hot, you know that? And I'm like, oh, thank you. And I kind of blush a little bit like that. She's like, no, for real, like, you're really cute. I want to stay with you, and, you know, we can do a meet-up again, maybe. And I'm like, for sure, I'm down. So at this point, we're kind of close to each other, and things lead to another. As we was, you know, getting in change to basically perform what we was going to do, she basically said that she was on a pill. And I was like, okay. But she was like, at the same time, please do not do it in me, though. As I'm about to finish up, what I can remember is I end up pulling her, but he fails, and he, like, goes in. And she's like, oh, no, Isaac, no, you didn't. And I'm like, you'll be fine, you're on the pill. And she's like, Isaac, no, it won't be fine. So she storms off into the bathroom, and I'm like, okay, there's definitely something wrong. She would not be acting like this if she was on it, you know, especially if she's been taking them at the correct times or whenever, you know, they've got to do it religiously, I've heard. So I got to the bathroom door, it's locked, and I'm like, Megan, what's wrong? And I'm like, Megan, what's wrong? Please tell me. And she's like, oh. She unlocks the door and comes outside, you know. She's got to leave something on at this point. She got a towel around her, two towels actually, and she's like, Isaac, I'm not on the bill. I'm like, what? And I get like, oh, shh, it's one of them bruh moments. I get really annoyed. I'm like, so you've lied to me, and I could be a dad. And she's like, I'm sorry, Isaac, but like, I doubt you'll be a dad because hardly any went in. And I'm like, I don't want to be risking that, you know. I don't want buns in the oven at this age. Jeez, like, it's just not acceptable. And let alone, we was both the same age. And not going to lie, I was pretty scared. I was scared for a while. She's like, Isaac, just leave it, you know. I'll do a pregnancy test. I'll do one, you know, for like a week, and I'll see how it goes. And I was like, so my heart's beating, and I can remember at this point, we literally just watched some of the TV, which was dead. We watched dead TV in this premiere, and there's a few channels, it was not good at all. So I can remember lying next to her. She falls asleep first and leaves me, and I am there watching this TV and scrolling through my phone, looking up at the ceiling in utter fear. Like, I was afraid, you know, because I didn't know if the girl next to me was going to be a baby mum of mine. So I'm worried. I end up texting my bro and I'm like, bro, you know, I'm with this girl. We done it. She said she was on the pill, but then she lied. But she said she's going to take some, you know, some test. And she's like, bro, I can't help you with this one. So that made me even more paranoid, more scared. So what I end up doing is, I end up worrying about it for hours and hours. It come to 4 a.m. I end up falling asleep. This has been literally 3 hours after she fell asleep. So I fall asleep. We wake up in the morning. I'm rough as hell. Rough. I'm fully rough. So, you know, we showered the night before, obviously, which I never mentioned, just a part of the story, which is no point. There's no point mentioning that part of the story, but yeah, we showered, so yeah, we woke up a bit fresh. I would have been way more dead and groggy if I never showered the night before, but I just, you know, decided to go into the shower this morning as well. So I had another shower. At this point, we used all the towels and all the towels. I feel sorry for one towel because it had all the, well, all the mine that had been in it, you know. But yeah, so after this point, I literally just get out of the shower, get dressed, Yeah, we just get a Starbucks, to be honest, you know. You can get like them little cakes and that, pretty cool. So yeah, we sit on the benches outside and it's a beautiful morning, to be honest. It's pretty cold, but it's a beautiful morning. It's one of them mornings that's like refreshing and it wakes you up. So after breakfast, we end up splitting ways. She ends up going, you know, back to the platform. I end up going to my platform. And she says, Isaac. And she held my hand. She's like, Isaac, as we split up, you know, to go back to our stations, I will let you know if I am, you know. But it's very unlikely that I will be pregnant. But if I am, I'll let you know, okay? I promise. I'm going to do a few times just to be 100% sure. And I'll let you know. Okay, she's like, don't worry, Isaac, everything will be fine. And I was like, okay. And I was like, okay, it'll be cool. So anyways, I get on the train, I'm feared, I'm worried. I end up getting off at the station, catching a bus to my town, going home. I speak with my mum. She's not pleased with me because, you know, of the night before what I told her. But anyway, we just dealt with it. But what I can remember is, a few days roll around and she messages me and she's like, Isaac, you know, I've done it a few times, we're all good. And I did message her throughout the days, but she wasn't really telling me. And it was just like on and off. And I kept asking and asking. And she's like, Isaac, just give me time. I need time. So a few days actually rolled around and she told me on one of the days. And I was like, oh, that's so good, because she basically said that, you know, she's not pregnant. Something about the lines on like the test. It never got to what it needed to be, so there's no way she could have been pregnant. And she's like, I'm still gonna do it again in a week. And I was like, okay, because, you know, she said she had a period and if she missed that, then she's definitely gonna do it. She said, no, everything was fine, we were still talking in the day, she'd done it again, everything was, you know, as normal, like she was not pregnant. She tells me again, everything was cool, everything was clear, and yeah, she was not pregnant. I was still worried after that for about 2 months, and I was like, okay, she's definitely not at this point. But yeah, if you enjoyed this story, please don't forget to leave a like. That was also as well the 2 months from December to January. That's when we was hearing some stuff about, you know, the virus, so I was worried a bit about that and a bit about the virus as well. And yeah, it was a weird timing, really weird timing. I didn't tell anyone, apart from my mate, to be honest. I didn't want no one to know. But yeah, if you enjoyed, you know, don't forget. as well. Subscribe, turn on bell notifications, and I'll see you in tomorrow's story. Peace.